Joe Kempson here, Tuesday night rostering supervisor, committee member, and yeah, level two referee. Hope everyone's doing well, and yeah, certainly looking forward to catching up with everyone at camp and hopefully back out on court soon. Just a quick couple of minutes here. I've got a short video in terms of I'll just go over some things about my life as a referee and what lessons I've learned and experiences I've had that's taught me some things over the years. I hope that you guys can get something out of it. I'll just go over some things as a referee and what I've learned, things from the committee and supervisor roles, and then also just what I've learned that's been able to help me in my personal life and going on to career and things like that, what sort of principles we have that help us out from there. So let's go. Yeah, so firstly, I'll just talk a couple of minutes about being a referee on court and what sort of principles and takeaways I had from being on court. Now, coming in as like a 15-year-old B grade, C grade, it's something that was a very new situation for me, and my main mindset was I go in, I do my couple of games, and I focus on myself. Being able to self-evaluate is something that I've always been pretty proud of, and being able to not rely on other people to force my development. This is me refereeing, and I'm the one who's in charge of how far I can go. So focusing on all of those details I can in a game, and going out on court and proving to myself that if there's a game that's easy, I'm going to prove to myself that, hey, I can control this at any stage. And if there's a game that's hard, I'm going on there and saying, I am going to show myself that this is a game that I can do, that I am good enough for this. So yeah, taking pride in your own development is something that I was really, really big on. Not being loud and obnoxious and trying to build a name for yourself by being self-absorbed and things like that, and trying to get a lot of attention. Focusing and putting your head down, putting in the work, self-evaluating around games, and being honest with yourself are the main takeaways to be as a referee, and how me personally, I was able to build a bit more confidence going up through the ranks and then build a name for yourself as a hard worker, and as someone who's actually caring about their own development, rather than just trying to be flashy and do all those other things that people might see from afar. Alright, so next up, talking about supervisor roles and within the committee and what sort of lessons I've taken from that over the years. So I think the first one I was going to mention in terms of mainly supervising is people who are looking to come on to being a supervisor. If you think maybe you're not ready, or you think something that's people aren't going to respect you or not going to listen to you, I would say don't underestimate the impact that you can have as a supervisor. Having the title itself is good, but having the mindset of being that I'm a leader within the branch was really something that was beneficial. I came on as a probably just like a fresh A grade, and it made me really look at things from a different point of view, saying I've been nominated and I've been accepted to be a supervisor. Now let me go out and show everyone else what I've learned and lead by example, whether I'm supervising or whether I'm refereeing on court. And then when it comes to the committee, a few years on the committee, when I came on, I was interested to see what sort of impact I could have. And getting in charge of the website was something that I was really, really intrigued with. And being able to redesign the website and really take pride in that side of VBRA Knox. And I can really see an impact that I've been able to have, which is really fulfilling for that. And just in general, what I look at for things like supervising and committee, as much as it might be, it's really beneficial to the branch and it helps everyone else out. At the least, what people will get out of it is you'll get development for yourself, and you'll be able to get fulfillment within being a leader, and being within a role of responsibility where you can take responsibility for some of the wins within the branch. And I look at people like Steve and Horst and Anthony and Ken in the past, over the last few years, that I've been able to have direct contact with, and seeing how much fulfillment they've gotten out of being involved at a higher level within the branch, really just shows how much it means to a lot of people, and how much, well, that's the sort of mindset that we can take into it as well. All right, and yeah, last quick section here. Yeah, just in terms of things I've taken from refereeing and principle that I've been able to take with me along to a career and along to just out in the real world. So I think that the main thing I'll stress here is punctuality and uniform, things that we're really big on at VBRA Knox, so making sure you're there 10 minutes before your session, and then also having your uniform all up to date, making sure your shirt's tucked in and proper uniform and all that. Those are things that are universal in in business and in careers and pretty much anywhere. If you're going to go to work, you've got to be on time and you've got to be wearing the right stuff. You've got to be presentable. And then also being able to speak to people and communication, things that we learned from day one at refereeing, are things that are going to be helping you across any sort of job or any sort of social situations that you have. So yeah, that's just a bit of personal stuff in terms of what I've taken and how it's made me be able to be a better person outside of refereeing as well. Awesome. Thanks for your time, everyone. Yeah, look forward to a next couple of videos coming up and see you all at camp. Awesome. Like and subscribe.